A lot of you have asked me various questions about materials and things that you might be able to do inside your home to block incoming noise. And this can be a very hard situation because everybody's home is different. You don't have a lot of agency over the incoming noise, so you have to deal with it in your home or on the path into your home. And it's hard to simulate. So what I've been working on is different iterations of a simulation using a couple of wood frames, one which represents your neighbor's apartment, and one which represents the inside of the wall or ceiling between your apartments, and various materials like drywall and mass-loaded vinyl and rockwool insulation and Homasote, and all of those are things we're going to demonstrate today. Now, this isn't perfect. And one reason why it isn't perfect is because the outside of this wood is exposed in this frame, and that creates some flanking noise. And in a real situation, in a real building, presumably all of the wood interior framing would be covered by drywall or by something. So it's not perfect, but I want you to listen closely and you'll be able to hear the difference between the different materials. Whether they work or not is another thing. So let's get started. So this represents your neighbor's apartment. So you've got this little rug here, if you're lucky enough to have a neighbor that uses rugs. And I glued 5/8 inch drywall around the inside of the wood. And this represents your neighbor's interior walls. I'm going to put this speaker in here, and it will play some audio from another Soundproofist video as part of the test. Then this piece of drywall here represents either your neighbor's ceiling, if they're a downstairs neighbor, or it could be their drywall on the other side of a shared wall between your apartments. You don't have any control over their walls or their ceiling. So now we've got this next layer of wood frame. And this represents the empty space that's between your apartments. It could be a wall space, or it could be a ceiling cavity. And then this piece of drywall represents the wall inside your home, or it could be your floor if you have a downstairs neighbor. Because a lot of flanking noise, a lot of sound sneaks out through these wood frames, I've tried putting cardboard around them on the outside, which is not as effective as drywall. And this model isn't to scale. The space between your neighbor and the depth of this wall would be bigger than it is here. But of course, if they have a TV against your shared wall or speakers in their ceiling, this could be pretty realistic. So the first test is for the hollow space between your two homes. And this is typical in a lot of American construction up until some of the newest building codes. A lot of walls and ceilings in American homes aren't insulated at all. So let's listen to that and look at the decibels. Now let's see what happens if we add some of the rockwool insulation. This is Rockwool Safe and Sound, and it does lower the volume, but you can still hear the audio. Now I'm going to add a little more mass inside the cavity with this piece of Homasote. It's a half inch thick, and it's pretty dense. You'll still hear the audio, although the decibels are slightly lower. And finally, let's add a layer of mass-loaded vinyl. I'm just going to put it across the top of the frame for now. And what's weird is that it didn't seem to help. Here's a vehicle turning around before I insert
before I put the insert in the window. And here's another car after I put the insert.
It actually seems like the decibels went up a little. I was surprised because so many people promote mass-loaded vinyl. So I have another take on it. This one was done without the extra cardboard around the top wood frame. But it's about the same. It ranges from 65 decibels to 72 decibels. That's interesting. So, in summary, this simulation shows the challenges of trying to reduce external noise inside the path to your home or at the receiving end inside your home. In all of these examples, the drywall is directly on the wood. There's no decoupling here. It shows how flanking noise can impact a targeted noise treatment, like when you soundproof one wall but not the others. We tested several materials to compare to a hollow wall. The hollow wall ranged from about 58 to 72 decibels. A wall with just rockwool insulation in it ranged from the low 50s to 68 decibels. A wall that combined rockwool insulation and Homasote in it ranged from the mid-50s to 64 decibels, so a little bit lower. And a wall with rockwool insulation, Homasote, and mass-loaded vinyl ranged from 65 to 73 decibels. In all of these cases, we could still hear the audio coming through the simulated walls, and most of it was low-frequency noise. So after all this, I wish I had a perfect solution for you. I wish that I could have showed you something today that like absolutely would soundproof your wall against your neighbor. But I didn't find it, and I'm really disappointed, just like you probably are. I'm going to keep looking for the best way to test this and for the best options for when you are on the other side of a noise source that you have no control over. All right, thanks for watching.
For more information about noise and acoustics, visit soundproofist.com.